Hi everyone, welcome to Dynamic Study. This is quiz class number 48 on previous year question paper. We have been discussing the question paper of June 2007, paper 2, and this is the third part of the video. Today we will discuss from question number 21. So let's start. Jindi Warobak movement relates to which literature? Option 1, Caribbean literature. Option 2, Canadian literature. Option 3, Australian literature. And option 4, New Zealand literature. The right answer is option number 3, Australian literature. Jindi Warobak movement first started in Adelaide in Australia in 1937, and the aim of this movement was to free the Australian art from foreign influences. It was inspired by Australian bush ballad tradition. Okay, this is some important detail related to Jindi Warobak movement. Please read something more about that. Okay, next. Question number 22. The Montreal group of poets championed the cause of option 1, modernist poetry, option 2, imagist poetry, option 3, symbolist poetry, and option 4, nature poetry. The correct option is option number 1, modernist poetry. Next question. The figure of the Abyssinian maid appears in which poem? Option 1, Kubla Khan. Option 2, Frost at Midnight. Option 3, Dejection and Ode. And option 4, Christabel. All of these poems are written by Samuel Taylor Coleridge. In which of these poems the figure of Abyssinian maid appears? The correct answer is Kubla Khan, option number 1. It was subtitled as A Vision in a Dream, a Fragment. Next. Coleridge's statement that imagination dissolves, diffuses, and dissipates in order to recreate relates to which kind of imagination? This statement is in Coleridge's famous critical work Biographia Literaria. So, which imagination is referred to as dissolves, diffuses, and dissipates in order to recreate? Option 1, secondary imagination. Option 2, isemplastic imagination. Option 3, fancy. And option 4, primary imagination. The correct answer is secondary imagination, option number 1. Next. Who is a writer of historical romances? Option 1, Walter Savage Landor. Option 2, Sir Walter Scott. Option 3, Jane Austen. And option 4, Emily Bronte. The correct answer is, of course, Sir Walter Scott, option number 2. Walter Scott is famous for writing historical romances. Next, which sequence is correct? There are the titles of some novels were given. You need to rearrange these novels according to their publication year. That means according to chronology, you need to arrange these novels. So, which sequence is correct? Option 1, Vanity Fair. Option 2, History of Henry Esmond. Option 3, Middlemarch. सॉरी ऑप्शन वन वैनिटी फेयर, हेनरी एस्मोंड, मिडिल मार्च, रिटर्न ऑफ द नेटिव। ऑप्शन टू हेनरी एस्मोंड, वैनिटी फेयर, मिडिल मार्च, द रिटर्न ऑफ द नेटिव। ऑप्शन थ्री मिडिल मार्च, द रिटर्न ऑफ द नेटिव, वैनिटी फेयर, हेनरी एस्मोंड। एंड ऑप्शन फोर द रिटर्न ऑफ द नेटिव, मिडिल मार्च, वैनिटी फेयर, हेनरी एस्मोंड। सो विच ऑप्शन इज इन करेक्ट क्रोनोलॉजिकल ऑर्डर? The correct option is option number one. These are the publication years. Vanity Fair was published in 1848. History of Henry Esmond in 1852. Middle March in 1871. And the Return of the Native in 1878. So please remember the publication year also and the chronological order. Next. Queen Victoria's reign, after whom the Victorian period is named, spans from? This is a very easy question. Option 1, 1833 to 1901. Option 2, 1837 to 1901. Option 3, 1840 to 1905. And option 4, 1842 to 1905. The correct option is option number 2. 1837 to 1901 is the time span of Queen Victoria. Queen Victoria's reign. Next, Pre-Raphaelite poetry is mainly concerned with option 1 narrative and style, option 2 narrative and nature, option 3 form and design, and option 4 form and value. The right answer is option number 3, form and design. Next, the concept of madwoman in the attic can be traced to which novel? Option 1, The Tenant of Wildfell Hall. Option 2, Villette. Option 3, Wuthering Heights. And option 4, Jane Eyre. Madwoman in the attic. The right answer is option number 4, Jane Eyre, written by Charlotte Bronte. The madwoman in the attic, The Woman Writer and the 19th Century Literary Imagination. This is the complete title of a book published in 1979, written by two writers, Sandra Gilbert and Susan Guber. They discussed the authors like Jane Austen, Mary Shelley, Charlotte Bronte, Emily Bronte, George Eliot, Elizabeth Barrett Browning, C.G. Rossetti, Emily Dickinson, the works of some important works of all these female writers are discussed here. And in Jane Eyre, who is the madwoman? The madwoman is Bartha, the wife of Mr. Rochester, who is imprisoned in the attic. So the madwoman in the attic concept came from this novel, Jane Eyre, by Charlotte Bronte. And this concept is again reworked by Jean Rhys in his novel White Sargasso Sea, which is considered as a prequel to Jane Eyre. Last question. Who among the Victorians is called the prophet of modern society? Option 1, John Ruskin. Option 2, Thomas Carlyle. Option 3, Thomas Babington Macaulay. And option 4, Matthew Arnold. The right option is option number 4, Matthew Arnold. Matthew Arnold is known as the prophet of modern society. So, this is the end of today's quiz class. Thank you very much. Keep on watching Dynamic Study. Keep on learning. Please like this video. Share this video with your friends. Also, share your views in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get more interesting videos. We will meet very soon in our next class. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.